Ahed, could we start by talking about the night you were arrested? What happened that night?
في البيت انت شو وقت اللي يطلع عليه؟
في البيت في البيت
وانت بتخوت ولك الطخاش خلص ولك الطخش.
Malik is now 16 years old. At 14, she was arrested at a checkpoint for an alleged knife attack on Israeli soldiers.
بعدين أخذوني على معسكر جيش بالقدس. هناك حققوا معي. صارت تصرخ علي وتحكي لي بدك توقع على هاي الورقة اللي بالعبرة وتسألني أسئلة كثير غريبة يعني. كنت أحكي لها لا انا ما عملت شيء بس يعني خلتني غصب عني اوقع على البركه. طبعا طول يوم الاعتقال كنت بدون لا اكل ولا ماي، وبعدين اخذوني على سجن هاشيرون.
Israel is the only country in the world where children are prosecuted through a dedicated juvenile military court system. Israeli military law is applied to Palestinian children in the West Bank because it is under military occupation. Every year, more than 500 Palestinian children, some as young as 12, are arrested by Israeli forces. Israel argues that the children it detains are threats to national security. More than 200 under 18-year-olds, like Nabil's 15-year-old son Mahmoud, are currently in detention. Mahmoud has been charged with stone throwing.
هذه رحت على المحكمة، أنا جبتها من المحكمة لاحت اتهام هذه، يعني شو تهمته شو موجهة إلى جبتها، ما بس أنا ما بعرف شو فيها، يعني ما بعرف شو فيها، مش واضحة بالنسبة إلي شو فيها. إنجليزي هي تكروها أنتو ولا عبري؟
The prison where Nabil's son is being held is less than an hour from the family home. We leave at 5:45 a.m. as it can take the family up to 6 hours to cross checkpoints.
احنا
مش على المعبر، على المعبر الغلبة على المعبر. تفتيش وقدم ورجع وروح واي شيء بترن المكنة، يعني غلبة بهدلة. بهدلة يعني عذاب. يعني كأننا احنا الاخرين معتقلين.
It was this slap that made global headlines. Then 16-year-old Ahed Tamimi spent 8 months in prison after it. Ahed alleges that she was mistreated on several occasions following her arrest.
وصلت مركز الشرطة اللي حققوا معي فيه. أول إشي قعدوني على كرسي بالزاوية وكلبسوني بإجري. فصرت يعني لا بقدر أحرك إيدي ولا إجري، مكلبش على الجهتين. أصعب إشي اللي هي فترة التحقيق اللي كانت 16 يوم.
التحقيق كان 16 يوم.
16 يوم 4 مرات.
And there was no lawyer present at all.
No.
Conversations involving Palestinian territories in Israel are polarizing and emotive, child detention especially so. But Saha Francis, a lawyer for Adamir, an organization that advocates for Palestinian prisoners in the West Bank, says the issue is not just moral, but legal.
When you raid a house after midnight in order to arrest a 14-year-old boy, it's not just against the boy himself. It's against the whole family. Imagine the father and the mother that they cannot protect their son, and they see their son is dragged out of his bed at night. I wouldn't believe it's about security, it's about control. It's about control and maintaining the oppression against the whole society, especially children. It's affecting a whole generation at the end of the day.
The most controversial form of incarceration is known as administrative detention. It allows the Israeli military to hold people without charge or trial on the basis of secret evidence that is not shown to the detainee or their lawyer. The military says administrative detainees pose a threat to the national security and their cases are therefore classified. Hossam went through this at the age of 16 for 14 months. During that time, he alleges he was held in solitary confinement, a practice that is strictly prohibited by international law for under-18s.
Did you ask if you could see a lawyer?
أنا بس انسجنت أصلا ما كنتش مركز وما كنتش عارف يعني شو مسوي كنت بفكر حالي يعني يومين ثلاث وراح أروح يعني أصلا ما كنتش طابب فيهم أساسا.
The Israeli military told the BBC that Hossam was held because of information which showed his intention to carry out a terror attack and his support for the Islamic State group. It also said he was assigned a lawyer in court, as are all minors. After 14 months in detention, Hossam was released without charge. As the Israeli military's chief prosecutor in the West Bank, Morris Hirsch prepared indictments against thousands of Palestinians, including hundreds of children.
The military system is specifically for the Palestinians because that's the requirement of international law. I often hear the claim that Palestinian minors are interrogated and forced to sign a confession in Hebrew. Great claim. Great claim. You're making a child sign a confession in a language that he doesn't understand and using that confession as a basis for his conviction. But it's simply not true. Most of the statements of the Palestinian minors are written in Arabic.
Most of it, but they set up to...
One second. Those that are written in Hebrew, no child was prosecuted based on a statement written in Hebrew. Rather, in every instance where there was a written statement, there was also an audio or audiovisual recording.
بس يعني بالمحكمة عرفت إنه كان فيها تهمتين محاولة قتل وحيزة سكين وكان في فيديو وأنا بالتحقيق يعني استعملوه بالمحكمة يعني المحامية تاعتي أخذته عشان تفرجي إنه هي ما حكت هيك وعشان هيك أنا انحكمت بس 8 شهور.
The IDF did not comment to the BBC on the case of Malak al-Khalith. The United Nations Convention on the Rights of the Child is a legally binding international agreement that states that children should only be arrested as a last resort. Israel is a signatory. The law says children should not be held in shackles, have prompt access to a lawyer and translators, and be treated with respect. For families, a visit to see their incarcerated children is long and interrupted by checkpoints. We were stopped for an hour and a half at Takamir checkpoint. Worried that press may attract more attention, the organisers of Nabil's bus requested that we didn't go on with them to the jail. Family visits are often needed to supply essential toiletries that may not always be provided for in prison, especially for girls.
What's it like for a girl to have her period inside jail?
يعني إنه بتحكي عن بنت مثلاً إنه تجيها الدورة بالسجن مثلاً ويكون عندها تحقيق أو محكمة إنه مثلاً إنه يعني يعطوها عدد محدد إنه تطلع مثلاً فوات صحية معها إنه العدد محدد إنه يكون فش يعني يمنعوها تروح على الحمام تغير إنه تضل ساعات طويلة وهي مش مغيرة فإنه هالإشي بأثر على نفسية البنت.
The Israeli military told the BBC that Ahed Tamimi accepted a plea deal for a number of charges.
في السجن ما كنت أحلم بإشي أصلاً جد يعني في السجن واحد بطل يشوف أي إشي فبيبطل يحلم بإشي لما تطلع بتصير تفكر بعدة أبعاد بتفكر بحياتك بتفكر بمستقبلك فبتحلم أحلام حلوة.
Israel currently denies Palestinian children detained in the West Bank legal protections granted to Israeli children. Yet agreed international law clearly states the same legal rights should apply to every person going through the judicial process, especially those under the age of 18.